Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergust 5000 back with more Dark Souls. In the last episode, we entered the DLC and we beat the Sanctuary Guardian, and now we're going to reverse our hollowing because I just feel like it. Because I don't feel like being an ugly witch. I feel like being baby-faced and cute under my nasty gargoyle helmet that I can finally... What? I have to use the other shield if I want to use this. Balderdash. Man, what a pain. Okay, what do I want to use here? I feel like I should probably use the crest shield? I don't know. That seems like probably a good idea. Okay, it looks like I'm going to need a little bit more, endurance before... I will bring my endurance up to 35 after all, I guess. I was only going to bring it to... 34, but I think I'm going to need some. I'm gonna want to be able to put on the Balder shield. So anyway, here we are in the DLC. Me and her, Karzin back of us. Karzin. No wait, hang on. I got that backwards. This is the Royal Wood, and one thing you'll notice about this area, which is curious, is that this area actually basically has the same layout as. The Darkroot Garden, and the area we were just in, the Ulusile Sanctuary, or the Ulusile, and I never know if it's, like, Ulusile or Ulusile, because I want to say Ulusile, but you might recognize that bridge, as that's the bridge we crossed before we fought Sif, and apparently Sif is actually a girl. I always forget that Sif is actually a girl, but, I don't know. So, yeah. So this Royal Wood is kind of a pain in the ass. Well, I don't know if it's really a pain in the ass of an area. It's kind of a whatever area, to be honest, because it's mostly just this big open space. Just like the Darkroot. Careful. You wouldn't want to hurt somebody, would you? These things are so funny. These are like the, because all the enemies in this area are basically like... It's like when you play Kirby Superstar Ultra and you beat Milky Way Wishes and you unlock Revenge of the King. And then... you go into Revenge of the King and everything is like, you know, green greens is turned into purple plants. Like, this is basically the purple plants to the Darkroot Garden's green greens. Do you think me a fool? Oh, shit. Whoa. Whoa. Have you perhaps taken me for a fool? I won't accept this mockery. Nice. And these guys are like the EX versions of the plant enemies, the basic like walking bush monsters. These are scarecrows, and they're really funny because they just like they attack with like farming tools, and those guys are the EX versions. Of the stone armors that we fought on our way to the Moonlight Butterfly, and they're substantially more dangerous, but, oh my. Ow! Okay, you got a delay on you. You got some Margit-ass bullshit. Cool, noted. Ooh! I've got a nickel in my pocket, and I'm really glad to see it. Okay, just... Whoa! There we go. Not so bad. They don't seem to have the same, Ooh, those guys are Twinkling Titan. I didn't know that. Wow, you look stupid when you're ragdolling. What's over here? I don't think I've ever been over here. I usually don't explore this area very thoroughly. The two other times in my life I've ever even been here. Oh, that's where... Okay. You have to explore this area and find other corpses to get the Guardian's garb. That makes sense. I'm gonna try and explore this area a little more thoroughly before, unless we get invaded, then I'll probably just make a run for it. Because I really don't want to. You guys, come at me all at once! Oh Jesus Christ! Balls. Dude, get out from behind the tree! Oh, here come the boss man. Hey, Whoa! Nice dodge. Dodge! Man, I can't believe I actually managed to avoid that. I cannot believe they actually let me get that roll off before he hit me with that swing. Shonov didn't look like he was going to. Man, you guys all got to aggro at once? You're jerks, man. You're right, assholes. Okay, I know the Scarecrow is going to outspeed. Yeah. So you can just... Gooey! Need a hug, gooey! Oh, wow. Nice. Two R1s and an R2 of the two-hand is enough to take those guys out. Two R1s and an R2 of the two-hand! What the hell is this guy saying? You sound like somebody talking in fighting game notation. Which, I mean, I guess is fair enough because that's basically what it is. You're just shortening everything down to, like, letters and numbers. Seria is bigger than I remember. Well, I mean, I guess it would be bigger than you remember. Oh, there's another one. There's another one, huh? We can't do anything in this building yet. This is the building that Shalquar is in the future. Because this area is actually in the past. We are in the past right now. That's, like, the whole thing. And in the future, there's a bridge here, but it's not here yet. And that's that other building is where we would find Shalquar. And this is a shortcut to the end of the area that we need to ride in from the other side to unlock. So I'm going to try and clear this place out, which shouldn't be too tough. This area is pretty easy to just run through after you've cleared it out. Ugh, you guys. Shit. That was not good. Whoa! Alright. And you're dead. Whoa! Okay, this guy's stronger, apparently. There we go. Did I get three? Maybe I actually hit that guy three times before. Hmm. Weird. Or maybe I hit him, like, during an attack and it did more damage with something. Let me go, after every single stanza of my speech. Just sound like a complete and utter tosser, or whatever they say. I don't know, whatever. So, I guess that's pretty much it. Not a whole lot to this area, clearly. Oh, we got somebody with a... Somebody who's not wearing a whole lot. Let's cross this bridge over here. Nothing, surely nothing will happen. Holy shit, I'm gonna die. Hello, Calamite. Oh, man, what a freaking awesome design. That is our super boss. We'll fight him later, and that is the one, like, guy, like, just to kind of emphasize how I am so excited to fight that guy, because that guy is one of, I think, literally three bosses in the entire franchise, in the entire trilogy that I've never fought before. The only other bosses... Shit. No, you asshole. I wasn't ready. The only other bosses in the series that I haven't fought before now are two bosses from the Dark Souls 2, the Dark Lurker and Sir Alun. Those are the only other two bosses in the entire franchise I haven't beaten before, but I've beaten every other, like... It's just funny to me because, like, Calamite, that guy, that dragon right there, is so freaking cool, and he's the first one of, like, sort of the brand of, like, dragon Dark Soul, like, dragon super bosses that would, who would then be succeeded by, I guess, technically Sin in Dark Souls 2, but I don't really consider him to be a super boss, but more appropriately by Meteor in Dark Souls 3, and then, and then Placidusac in Elden Ring, and all three of those bosses I've basically fought in reverse order. I fought Placidusac first, and then Meteor I finally fought just like a couple weeks ago on stream for the first time. And now, I'm finally going to fight Calamite for the first time ever in this LP. I meant to do it on my practice run, but I just straight up forgot to. I literally just forgot to fight him, and then I accidentally beat the final boss. And once you beat the final boss and activate the ending, it pushes you directly in. Like, once you beat the final boss, you can't, like, play anymore. Like, you have to trigger an ending. Oof, that was nerve-wracking. Okay, I don't know this part of the area very well. I actually have no idea where I am. Like, I don't know what's... Because normally I only go through this area, like, one time, and then I never even have to think about it ever. That's death. Hugh. What do we got? Guardian Helm! More garbage I'm never gonna use. Sweet. This is extremely, extremely nerve-wracking. Oh, hi! Jeez. What is that? That's just a gnarled tree stump. Okay. I saw that and I thought it was gonna like... Because I feel like there's probably an enemy in this area that I've straight up never... What the hell is this? Elizabeth's Mushroom. Oh, that's actually... I believe that's like a stronger version of the Green Blossoms. Or it might actually just heal you. Greatly restores HP for a limited duration. Okay, yeah, so that's actually more like a Radiant Life Gem. Which, those aren't in this game. That's a Dark Souls 2 thing. Dark Souls 2 introduced Life Gems, which you could actually, like, grind as many of them as you wanted, and they were basically, like, just supplemented your Estus Flasks. So if you wanted to have more HP, if you wanted to have more healing items, you could just... I don't remember how... I don't think you could actually, like, just grind them. Like, I don't think any enemies actually, like, any enemies actually, like, dropped them. But... But. It was definitely possible to, like, stockpile them and use them if you desperately needed more healing. And they healed you, like, really slowly, and they usually, like, didn't heal you as much as your Estus, so it was, like, really nice to just have something, like, if you wanted a top-off, and it would be a waste to use an Estus, but you didn't want to walk into the net. You know, if you were missing, if your Estus heals, like, 80% of your bar, and you're missing 40% of your bar, then using an Estus is gonna feel like a waste, but you might not want to walk into a fight with only 60% of your health. Like, you might not be confident in your ability to survive a fight on 60% of your HP. Ooh, goes Great Arrow. Go. That's a character that I don't think I've ever actually even met before, either, because Go is actually instrumental in accessing the fight with Calamite, and I don't think I've ever even unlocked the fight with Calamite. I might have, on my first playthrough, like, years ago. Like, almost 10 years ago, I think. Well, no, it was less than 10 years ago. It was closer to, like, six or seven years ago. Yeah, on my first playthrough, like, 6 or 7 years ago, I might have done the preamble, and I might have even gone so far as to try to fight Calamite once and just, like, die horribly. But, truth be told, I really don't remember. Oh, jeez, here they come. Here he comes to wreck the day! Mr. Reed! Sorry, Your Honor. Yeah, I just love how this whole area is basically just, like, it's literally, like, it's the purple plants of... It's the purple plants to the Darkroot Gardens Green Greens, and I just find that so delightful. How, like, basically every enemy in this area is, like, is a kind of a drew kind of a dark, fucked up version of an enemy from Darkroot Garden. Just a little twist into my, just a little glimpse into my twisted reality. Like, oh, that's it, that's what I have to, like, theme this episode's title and description around, is that whole thing. Drew, like, a dark, fucked up version of the Darkroot Garden. And that's actually why it's called the Darkroot Garden, is because this area is actually, like, where, as you can see right here, this is the abyss. Like, this is the abyss, that the same abyss that we fought the four kings in. In the past, it was like, it was basically like breaking through the barrier into the over, into like the world, and it was coming in through Darkroot Garden, and that's why it's called Darkroot Garden. You guys having a good time? Because I kind of want to, I know. Oh, jeez. Ah, fuck. Where? Hang on. Where is she? Because I would really, really like to open the shortcut before this person fucks my face in. But I've got a lot of enemies between me and there. I think that's the building right there that I need to get to. So let me try. That's a lot of guys. I am now intimidated by the number of... You asshole! Oh my god! Oh my god. I don't believe this shit. Hi. Bye. Okay, there's the boss. But first I'm gonna run over here and activate the shortcut. I really, really do not want to die to this invader before I activate this shortcut. Okay. Thank God. Yeah, she must have warped in like right next to the boss. Right next to the boss gate. All right. Hello. Wait, where are you going? Hey, where are you going? Hey, please don't kick my ass. I'm gonna drink all my Estus. What are you doing? Lady, really? Is that strictly necessary? Okay. No honor, huh? What? What's that? Aww. Ay. What? I couldn't roll! Nah, you know what? I'm not gonna indict you. The fact that you gave me an indictment suggests to me that you felt bad for that. So, you know what? I'm gonna give you the benefit of the doubt. The fact that you left me an indictment suggests to me that either you wanted me to indict you, or you realized a second too late that I was trying to be chivalrous and felt bad. And either way, well, I guess if you wanted to be indicted, I would feel kind of bad. You know what I actually did on that last episode, or that previous episode where I got invaded by that guy in the Duke's archives, was I actually, I tagged the video with both my player name and their player name, just on the off chance that, you know, somebody might be thinking, like, oh, I wonder if I could, like, just on the off chance that they try to, like, search the usernames on Google to see if they can find that, you know, on the off chance that somebody was recording it, which they probably wouldn't realize is actually the case, but they might be curious to see. You know what I should have done? After I picked up that indictment, I should have shrugged at them after they backstabbed me. That would have been funny. Okay, anyway. Thankfully, once you've unlocked the shortcut, it's pretty trivial to get through here. All you gotta do is hug the right wall, and you only have to deal with those first two scarecrows. Yeah, pretty easy stuff. And you can set this elevator up, just in case you, like, aggro somebody on the walk to this elevator. You can also do the old classic, which is to activate the elevator and then quickly run off of it so that it's waiting for you up at the top the next time you die. Also, who's this fellow? This guy looks like he came out right out of Bloodborne, and that might actually be the case, because...
Ah, let me guess. snatched by a shadowy limb and dragged off to the past?
Yep, that's right.
Yes, of course.
Exactly what happened to me. We are both strangers in this strange land. But
strangely, there are now two strangers of us. It's like, I am the spirit of the Lord. I have borrowed the Lord's body to talk to you for a short while, Lord. Bavmorda, the Lord, who I placed in the Lord's world, has made my Lord voice inaudible, and she is trying to conquer the Lord. So take... Now I will lordly put my strength into this Lord crystal. Take it, my Lord, and go climb the West Lord Tower. You have the Lord! Okay, anyway. What's down here? Oh, this is like the riverbed. And I totally forgot this area even existed on my until I stumbled into it on my last run. This is, I believe, the path you have to take to eventually get to Calamite. But we can't do that yet because we haven't... Because at the moment, Calamite is going to be flying around invincibly in the sky. And I think if we try to approach where we would normally fight him... This is just a Doberman. This is just a dog. Like, I mean, this is literally just a dog. It's not even like a zombie dog. It's literally just a dog. Almost makes you feel a little bad. Yeah, I am curious, actually, though. I'm also curious to see if I can get any... See, the thing is, like, I'm trying to think, like, do I want to try to fight the boss in this video? Because I really don't want to fight this boss. I don't want this boss to be an afterthought, because the boss of the Royal Wood is literally one of the highlights of the entire game. Because we're about to fight Artorias, the same guy who the ring used to belong to that we used to fight the four kings, Artorias the Abysswalker. The guy, literally, this entire DLC, when it was originally released, this DLC area, the DLC expansion is called Artorias the Abysswalker, or Artorias of the Abyss. So, like, literally the entire DLC is named after this guy, and he's the boss of the Royal Wood. And he's a really, really intense fight, and I'm really looking forward to it. Because, yeah, it's like top-tier stuff. There's, like, just lumber here. What the heck? This is weird. Okay, yeah, this must be the door. Okay, that's where the boss... This is where the boss fog must be. Imminent Drake. This is where the boss fog must be. For, Calamite. Weakness Giant. I don't particularly want to walk through here while I'm carrying all these souls. I'm gonna pause and go back to the bonfire and use some of these souls to level up, get our endurance up to 35, and then where we can leave it for the rest of the playthrough. And then, I'll meet you back down here. So, be right back. God, I really wish I'd thought to shrug at them. That would have been so fucking funny. There we go. 90 equip load. And that's without Havel's ring. Jeez. Grr, I still need 2 more points of equip load before I can fast roll with the Baldur Shield! Oh my god, that's a Vagrant. Holy shit. Oh my god, that's a Vagrant over there. Is that what's making that sound? Listen to that. Oh my god, that's so creepy. It's like... It's making like a tinkling, like wistful, windy sound, but it's also like moaning. Oh, okay. I need to go kill that thing. I can count the number of times I've seen a Vagrant on one hand, and I am not passing that opportunity up. That is so freaking. Maybe. Oh, is it these? Okay, I guess the torches were what was making the high pitched sound, but. I don't know what was making that moaning. That was creepy. I don't think Vagrants make noise. Because I feel like I would have noticed. There's also something over here. What is this? Soul of a Proud Knight. Wow, that's pretty lackluster, to be honest. Get back here, asshole. Okay, Vagrant, your turn. What's up, dude? Man! Man, a watermelon! Give me your spoils, sir! Wow. Oh, man. Twin humanities. Can I make this jump? Hew-hup! Wee-hoo! Nice. That was awesome. There was literally no reason for me to do that. Because now I just have to sneak past all these dumbasses over here. But, oh well. Alright, let's go see what happens if we try to enter Calamite's boss arena right now. Because I suspect what's going to happen is he's going to swoop over, he's going to swoop overhead and basically carpet bomb my ass with fire. Because I think this guy actually has, like, black flame fire breath. Like the stuff that Fredede, that Sister Fredede uses in DS3. Sister Fredede. Would you like French Fredede with it? And a particular... I'll drink my free Estus that I got from somebody kindling that bonfire, which that's honestly a bonfire that I should be kindling. There's no reason not to... Hew-hup. Gotta get the timing down. Like that. Boom, 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 baby. Yeah, gotta get the timing down. Stupid. Stupid, 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 stupid. Ha-boom. Alright, what do we got? Is Calamite gonna just incinerate my ass from the sky? Oh, somebody just walked out. Maybe they just beat him. Wait a second, is this not where he is? Is there an elevator here? Oh, there he is. Hey, dude! Jeez, man. Yeah, down this ladder. Yeah, that's the arena, alright. This is actually the same area where the Hydra is in the future, which is really cool. This is where you, this is the same ladder you can take. I wonder if that area where the portal is actually still here. Or was here in the past. Because I have a... Oh, man, the camera's all zoomed out. Oh, no, I guess not. The little corridor where normally you would... Oh, my God. Man, this is epic. Any second now, he's going to swoosh right in and just... Uh-oh. Yeah, that's it. Holy shit. Ooh. That hurt. Get up. Get up, Duke dude. I want that last item. I guess this is one last bombing run for the road. Ooh. Oh, nice. Ow, 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 ow. Wait, stop. Please. I want to get the item. I want to get the item and then you can kill me. I'm running. You'll never take me alive. Oh, boy. Okay, anyway. I think that's going to do it for this episode of Dark Souls. Next time we will fight the boss of the Royal Wood, and it's going to be awesome. I'll see you then. Bye. Man, that one moved me so far forward, the camera could barely keep up.